I'm sharing the syllabus of the course. Do you see the page?
Yes.
So what we are going to do in the beginning, I will take initiative of the discussion on the topics first, second, third. That is introduction to philosophy, which is of course my area. So I will be discussing the definitions of philosophy and what is its nature, what is the essential practice in philosophy. And for that, whatever concepts are necessary, we will see that. And then I will introduce major branches of philosophy in which ethics is one of the branches. So we will see in little details what are the ethical concerns, and then we will narrow down it to the specific purpose for which we are conducting this course, following the moral principles or moral theories applicable to our research activity, right? So we are going to engage ourselves in different research activities in which we will be dealing with animate as well as inanimate objects. So what should be our concern to deal with animate and inanimate objects in our research? Then we will have intellectual honesty and research integrity theme. That is what we are looking for from all the researchers. Doesn't matter whether anyone is in PhD or in any other profession. So this is the whole objective of having this course. And we are looking for, in fact, this very practice. We need to be intellectually honest, and we must conduct our research with integrity, right? So regarding the first unit, I will take care of these points. And then what I decided that regarding units second and third, I will form a group of all of you, including students from different backgrounds. So I will try to make heterogeneous groups. And for the remaining 10 topics, we have almost 40 students in our groups, and there are 10 topics. So each group will have four or five students. And the tasks which I will assign for each group, these different topics will be given to separate groups. And what I expect from each group of four or five students to write about 2,000 words on the particular topic which will be assigned to you. And I will be assigning topics and sending it through email to each group. And I expect that the leader, I will fix one student as coordinator or leader, whatever you wish to call. And the role of the coordinator will be to write an introduction and also summarize the thing in the last. So introduction and conclusion will be given to the coordinator or leader of the group. And then the remaining students will be contributing different sections. So once I form a group, what I expect that you will interact among yourselves and assign different issues, different topics, distribute it among yourselves. So I will expect one section contributed by each student towards these 2,000 words. So one student will be required to at most write just 500 words. So assuming that four or five are going to be part of that, it should be at least 2,000 words. You can go even for a greater length. That will be the job. So each student will contribute to a definite section in the write-up. And then I will look for, I will give the details in a page, how you are going to pursue that. So I will look for definite referencing in the whole document. And for referencing purpose, I wish that there should be at least 4 journal articles. They should be used for developing the idea in that write-up. There should be at least 4 books. Among these 4 books, one should be by single author, at least one. These are at least. You can always go for greater quantity. So at least one book by single author, at least one book by more than one author, and at least one book which is edited book. So 4 journal articles, 4 books, these are minimum you will be using as resource, and some of the resources I will supply. The material which I am going to use, I will share with all of you. And the resources which you are going to use for your write-up, that you need to take care, you have to gather, and I will tell the sources from where you can get the material. Online sources are there, and I hope that if you come across any nice website or nice source of information, so you please share with all of us. So that is the expectation for you. And if you look at the evaluation pattern, so this course will have one mid-semester examination, which will continue in this semester. So I will be telling you precisely the date. I have not looked at the calendar, the dates of the examination. So one mid-semester examination will be conducted. That will be for 30 marks. And then we have this 2,000 words, or more than 2,000 words, as you wish. But only thing is that every member of the group will contribute to a definite section, and your performance will be based on the way you have contributed to the section and the quality of material which you have used, and the coherence and logicality of the section which you write. So I will be asking the team leader to specify who has contributed to which section, right? So that detail I will provide, and you need to just mention that who has contributed to his section. So your evaluation for 20 marks will be based on that write-up, 2,000 words or more. And then I will ask every group to present that title on a particular date on Friday. So we will have all our classes on Friday for 2 hours. So 1 hour will be reserved for presentation of this write-up which you write. And I will specify the dates on which a particular topic is to be presented. So I hope you will be ready by then. And then of course you can manage your time so that you have write-up ready and you present it in the class session. In between also, I will request some of my colleagues who are experts in different areas for our ethics as well as some legal dimension of research. So I'll request them also to present their viewpoints in our classes. So when we have a class session which is meant for presentation, in fact, we will have presentation throughout. So first 4 topics will be presented by me initially, and I will conduct it with the help of a definite study material, and I'll share it, and everyone is supposed to go through the material and come prepared and ask questions in the class, have interaction. And I am, as I said, one of the learners. So I will contribute my part, and I expect that whatever nice thing comes to your mind, you please share with the group. So we will have benefit. We will have this exchange of ideas, and that will be beneficial for all of us. So 30 marks will be for mid-semester. 20 marks will be based on your write-up and the way you present. So that evaluation is required. And then we will have the major examination, which will be for 50 marks. So major examination, how the examination is going to be conducted, we will come to know in time from our Dean of Academic Affairs. So I will inform accordingly. And consider the topics which are already given in the syllabus. They will be assigned to separate groups, and the group is supposed to make a coherent write-up so that major issues are not left, right? So this way we are going to conduct, and then along with whatever we discuss in our class, certain practice sessions will be there. So that I will take care. I will conduct brief activities during our class. So we will do certain practice. So this is related to our method and what we are going to do during the study of this course. Now, very obvious question I ask, why do you want to do PhD? Why do you want to have research for yourself? So you have diverse interests. Some are interested in learning about the nature of the material objects. Some are interested to learning the organic or what we call organisms and how they behave. And most of you are from sciences and engineering. We have one student from humanities, from English literature. So from science, management, engineering, and humanities, social science, that is economics. So we have all the major branches of higher studies, and you belong to all of these branches. This class is really very promising, very interesting combination of individuals. And this is a representation, in fact. It's a great representation of all the major disciplines of higher studies, right? And as a researcher, we are on the peak of, in fact, our learning. We are not school children. We are not college students. We are not part of any small degree program. This is a research program, right? And the ultimate objective of a research is to produce a coherent, interesting document for the evaluation. That's the ultimate objective which you are looking for during this program, right? So you are finally going to present a thesis for the evaluation of others. So certainly you'll be writing it for the consideration of others, which means whatever you do, you must keep this fact in mind that this is going to be evaluated by someone, right? So why we are going to do all the exercises in this course, this is geared towards this greater objective for your thesis evaluation. So all the things which are required, we will try to have at least a sample of that during this course, right? So that is our academic objective. Second objective which we want to have is to sensitize ourselves related to different moral concerns. Normally, we have academic concerns. We have, let us say, concerns for technology, concern for science, concern for social reality, etc. Ultimately, what we are going to do, that must be with a human face, right? And here comes the role of morality. Here comes the role of ethics. Whatever we do, we need to keep this fact in mind always, that this must be useful for the society. This must be useful to facilitate the ease of our life. This must be useful for common people. That should be our broader objective in doing anything, in fact. So for that, of course, we have learned so many things, starting from our nursery classes or from our lower KG classes up to this level. We have gone through so many course books. We have encountered so many teachers, so many administrative officers up to this stage, right? So we are almost mature, filled, and the greatest advantage for having this kind of status is that we can bank on our experience. The greatest disadvantage of having this kind of situation is that we are almost immune to any kind of learning. That's the problem, right? So our experience is, on the one hand, a great asset. On the other hand, it is a hurdle in learning. Now, we don't want to lose our asset, nor we want to have any hurdle in our learning, right? And therefore, whenever we participate in any discussion, let us be open. Let us be open to any kind of viewpoints. Let us be open to any kind of suggestion. And then, of course, we are the ultimate decision makers, right? So we are going to choose what we are going to do with that and how we are going to do that. There is no, absolutely no pretension to teach you, in fact. Absolutely no pretension in this course to teach you, because we all are taught, we have learned so many things. So now what we are going to do in this course, we are going to share our experience and learn from each other. So I will be taking initiative for certain topics of learning, and I expect that each of you will be taking initiative for the other topics of learning, right? So this way we will try to organize, conduct the class sessions. In the end, I give a general advice for all of you. Since you are in a PhD program, and PhD program is in fact not a short program, some of you will be for 4 years or for 5 years, some may go for 6 years even. So it's relatively long duration. It's a relatively long duration than the courses which you have undergone so far. Now, because of this, it is necessary that we must take care of our health properly. Because unless we are healthy, we are physically fit, we are not going to fare well during this 4, 5, 6 years, right? So for that, I have a general advice that please do some exercise every day in the morning with empty stomach. Some of you must be doing that, and I hope all of you are doing that. Those have less time, please manage your time schedule in such a way that you engage in some physical exercise every day in the morning, and take care of your spine well. Spine is the backbone, what we call, of our existence, in fact. How healthy we are, that is determined by the nature of our spine, how healthy spine we have. And the greatest character of a healthy spine to me is its flexibility. Our spine is flexible, right? So how to ensure the flexibility of our spine? There are many exercises given. You please consult those exercises and try to maintain a genuine health. What I do, let me share my experience for everyday way of living. When I get up in the morning, I take almost 1 liter lukewarm water. Just after washing my face, I drink almost 1 liter lukewarm water. This is in my case. Some of you may like to have that for yourself. And after having that water, I go to washroom and get fresh, and then I do some exercise, in fact, some yogasanas. And since most of us are confined to our homes, and our homes are the safest place nowadays because of the crisis. So do some physical exercise inside of your room, wherever you are. And if you are lucky enough, some of you are certainly in this campus, and our campus is very beautiful, and it's more or less very safe. So those who are lucky enough nowadays, they are here, and I hope some of you are certainly in such situations wherever you are. So please take care of the situation and then do physical exercise, maintain flexibility of our spine, and maintain right posture of sitting and using your body properly, right? So take care of your health, because you are being part of this program for a longer duration, 4, 5, 6 years. So take care of your health properly. Second general advice is that now we are in direct interaction with our teachers. You might have been part of some programs where you were part of a larger group, and that larger group may not have very specific attention of the teacher or the guide towards yourself. So now you are in a research program where you have your supervisor, and supervisor is supposed to guide you in the area in which you are working, tell some brief information or give some brief knowledge about the basic material which you are going to use. But greater responsibility is on your part, because it is your thesis. Remember, normally people say that it's a joint project of supervisor and student. I have a different opinion, that don't try to put any pressure on the supervisor. Take full responsibility of your research project and be the master of your work, which you are going to do, right? Don't allow anyone to take credit of that in greater detail, right? So that part we will take up in the research concerns, ethics concerns. We will discuss briefly how we are going to do that. But take full responsibility of your work. Explore maximally. Whenever you meet your supervisor, have full homework and go with a definite goal that you are going to discuss this very topic on this day with your supervisor with prior appointment. Okay. So now you are in a situation where you have a direct interaction with your teacher, with your supervisor, and you. Now, for that, to maintain that, there is a beautiful saying in Sanskrit. What it is? Sahana vavatu, sahano bhunaktu, sahaviryam karavavahai, tejasinavadhitamastu, mavidishavahai. Sahana vavatu. Let us be protected together. Sahanau avatu. Sahanau. Nau is two, do. Sanskrit mein dual degree aata hai. Sahanau. Nau kaun hai yahan? Do kaun hai? Supervisor or student? So in this sloka, there is a pious wish and a sincere commitment towards the fact that let us be protected together. Sahana vavatu. Avatu means raksha ho. Hum dono ki raksha ho. Supervisor, student, teacher, student. And I would say for all learners, right? So the facilitator who is facilitating the learning and the people who are engaged in learning, right? These two. So let us be protected together. Sahano bhunaktu. Let us be nourished properly together. Sahana vavatu, sahanau bhunaktu, saha viryam karavavahai. Let us engage ourselves in such a meaningful manner that we build up upon our competence. We enhance our competence together. So sahana vavatu, being protected together, sahanau bhunaktu, being nourished together, saha viryam karvavahai, building our competence together, tejas sinavadhitamastu. Let us have the glory flourishing to its maximum together, right? And then in the end, ma vidishavahai. Let us not have the element of hate or jealousy among ourselves. Now, this is the pious wish which we have in this beautiful saying, and this is true of any situation of learning. So let us have that kind of situation and maintain that. Then the third thing which I wish to impress upon all of you, you have just joined the PhD program. So I sincerely advise that please, each of you plant at least 5 trees. And if possible, plant 5 trees which are fruitful. Mango tree, guava tree, or any fruit which you are enjoying, maybe papaya, or try to manage plantation of 5 trees before July. In fact, July, August would be the rainy season. So starting from now up to August or maybe September, you can go. In this duration, try to manage plantation of at least 5 trees. And take care of those trees well, and be vigilant that these trees are progressing along with the progress in your thesis. Whatever your work going to produce, every day you will have some new leaves in that work. And let us have a kind of co-extension of this new leaf in our plants, right? So let us plant at least 5 trees and take well care of. If you can do more, that is fine. Some of you may be in a situation where you have proper land, your own land, there you can plant in a suitable place so that they are not cut because of any other construction activities. So work out the place of plantation. Those who are inside the campus, they have more opportunity. They can plant trees. Enough of space is there. If you have any worry regarding that, you please come to me. I will consult the engineering wing, and we will specify a place where you can plant your trees. And it is not just planting and forgetting the tree. You please take care of the tree for all duration. So by the time you will be submitting your thesis or getting your degree awarded, your plant will be for 4 or 5 or 6 years. And you will enjoy seeing that plant which developed along with your thesis work, right? So this is a kind of social activity which I request all of you, please do it wherever you are. And if you don't have any land, you may be somewhere in cities where you don't know where to plant the tree. You just go outside of the city or may see the roadside and specify certain places where you can easily plant. Nobody will object to that. If you are in rural areas, there may be your own land or the land of Gram Panchayat. Nobody will object to you planting that tree, but let us have proper justification wherever we are going to plant that tree. Let us ensure that nobody is offended or nobody is objecting to that. With that precaution, let us do that exercise before September this year. Okay, So that is my sincere request for all of you. And I close my sharing now, and I wish to hear some suggestions, some advices regarding the way we are going to conduct this course. We are going to have our classes on every Friday, 9 to 11. And during this period, even if it is holiday, we are going to meet. If I am engaged somewhere, I will assign any of you to take care of the activity of coordination of the class. So we let us do things in such a way that we are not going to miss even a single Friday for meeting. And of course, some may be busy, some someday unavoidable activities sometimes come. So some of us may not be able to join every class, but the minimum requirement is that everyone meets the standard of our class protocol, and that is 75% minimum to be safe. So please try to be punctual in the class. What I will do, because of network issues, there are some disturbances in between. So I will mark first attendance at 9:05. The second attendance I will again collect at 9:45, after 40 minutes. And then the next attendance I will mark at 10:30, or maybe in the end, in fact, not 10:30, in the end. Okay. So 15 minutes after we begin our class. Second one, almost during the middle of our class, and the last one in the end. So that if you miss one any of these, I wish that you try to join 5 minutes at least before we begin our class, and you participate in the discussion. And in between, due to some network issue, it happens, your attendance will not be left out. So I will see all these three markings every week, and I will clarify the dates and all the topics which you are going to take up for your presentation, for your learning. So this way we are going to conduct the course. So you're welcome to share any of your thought or any concern which you have. So it's open for all of us. Aap kuch apni baat share karna chahein, kuch advice karna chahein, suggest karna chahein, so that we maximize our learning in this course.
Amit sir?
Jai, bilkul, bataiye.
I missed out on the part when you were telling about the evaluation due to some network issue. Can you just let me know?
This is our usual semester evaluation. We are going to have one mid-semester, and then in the end, we will have major examination. And then for assignment and quiz, we have fixed 20 marks, and that will be based on the write-up, which I'm going to assign for each group. So 2000 plus words, everyone will be concerned about that. So I will be giving a clear guideline and expectation in a page. So that would be the pattern of evaluation. So 20 marks for write-up, 30 marks for mid-semester, and 50 marks. How examinations are going to be conducted, I'm looking for some guideline from our academic wing. So okay, the moment they inform us, we will communicate to you.
Fine, sir. Thank you.
Yes. Aur bhi aap kuch baat kar sakte hain, Trapti Pathak, do we have to submit article in next class? And sir, what
can you hear me?
Let me just respond to first one. Trapti Pathak asked whether she is supposed to submit article in the next class. First, you need to prepare the article. The group will prepare the article, and then the article will be presented in the class, and there will be discussion on that. And after getting feedback from all of participants, you will have, you may feel like revising some part of that, or you may feel like including something in your article. So once you do it, then I will tell you the date by which you will complete your write-up and then submit it. Yes, Tariq.
Sir, can we have two colors of 1 hour each instead of this 1 2 hour colors, so that it may not get bored?
This is a problem on my part because I have many classes this semester, so I could very miserly specified this space 9 to 11. I don't have, in fact, time for myself, so it would be stressing on me, and making any change is difficult in my case because all of our classes are hybrid kind of classes. That means students coming from different schools. So any change in the schedule requires a huge exercise on consulting different heads and then managing.
So, no worries, sir, but I was just asking because this long classes then get bored, that's why.
Once today it was in fact mostly on my part, so you all are attending it online, so keep something to eat in between, so you can have some snacks or something to eat.
Right, sir, can't. This is the month of Ramadan, so we are keeping fast.
And keep some water also along with you.
No worries, right? Sir. Thank you.
Yes, so take care of in between churning. In fact, when you eat something, that releases the tension and also provides energy for sustaining for longer duration.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
And moreover, we all are in the research activity, right? So it does require this kind of sacrifice to spend longer duration on table or on in labs or in field, right? So let us develop that habit of sitting for longer duration, and that this class can also be an opportunity. And this is one class in a week, so I think it should be manageable for all of us.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Any other concern from anyone?
Sir, can we have the recording of lecture after the lecture?
Because certainly. Today I have turned on recording whenever I started the procedural thing. So these lectures will be recorded, and I will put all of them in a file and share it with you, right? So every lecture will be there in that file in my Google Drive, and that drive will be shared with all of you. So it won't be a difficulty. I suppose because of some very urgent work, you miss some class, so you will get the recording.
Okay.
So it will be there. Any other concern?
No, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
Please share the PDF file of the syllabus and some reference of the books.
Certainly. In fact, some books are already prescribed in the syllabus itself. So I am also downloading those books. So there is one website from where we can get books downloaded. Let me just write in the chat box. I don't know if it is perfectly ethical, but since it is available, we use it. And since we are not making any profit,
we can download books from Google Drive.
Yes. So this is, can you see this website I'm sharing with you?
Google Drive.
Yes,
gen.lib.rus.ec. So there are books, in fact, if you search for a title or for any author name, you will get many resources. And then our university has subscribed Science Direct, and there is many material on JSTOR. So I hope you will be using all these resources which are available with us. And of course, internet is there, so largely we will depend on internet material, and that is rather easy for all of us to access.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Anything else? Okay, so this is all for today's first session, and we will discuss our topics, and I will chalk out the plan and share with all of you. So see you on next Friday then. Bye for now. Take care.
Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you.